Sup guys, Heeking here, bringing you a Resident Evil tier list. So yeah, I thought this would be a fun thing to do. And I thought, yeah, why not do one of these? So yeah, I'm going to go or try to go through all the Resident Evil games I've played and rank them basically. So this should be fun. Remember to like and subscribe guys. And yeah, let's do this. So yeah, just have to double check where we're at this point. I'm going to wait for the 2 minute mark here because I've already set it up. Let me put it a bit more back there. Oh, yeah. And 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. So yeah, let's see, we got, start with the first Resident Evil, of course, Resident Evil 1 from 1996. I'm gonna put it on good. Do I think it's great? No, I think there's some flaws to this game, but as a starter to the franchise, I think it's bloody brilliant. And unique in terms of how you can play it, because you know the difficulty setting for this game is specifically tied to which character you pick. So Jill's basically easy, normal mode, and Chris is hard mode. But I like how, depending on which direction you go with Jill, like in the beginning of the game, like if you decide to go upstairs first or downstairs, and which weapon you get, or the area that leads to that weapon you get. So if you go for the route that leads to the shotgun, Barry will save you and you get a much easier time out of the game, because Barry's going to pop up here and there and save your life. But if you decide to leave the downstairs room and go upstairs to the balcony to get the grenade launcher from Forrest's corpse, you meet Barry and it's a very suspicious, and then you know the story sort of changes there and the game becomes basically similar to Chris's campaign. So I thought that was a really clever touch there, makes the replay value very high. And yeah, like good music as well, good soundtrack, I think, at least for this version compared to the director's cut. But yeah, definitely a good first outer, you know. Then we got Resident Evil 2. That's going straight to great, because it's one of the best sequels. It introduced us to Leon, to Claire, to the freaking G-Virus, and Ada and Sherry. Just absolute brilliance. The way they created the different alternative scenarios. So you get two campaigns, basically, and each campaign has two scenarios. And they intercross with each other, you know, Leon and Claire. So you got Leon A, Claire B, or if you play it all the way around, you got Claire A, Leon B, which apparently is the actual main storyline. But I always prefer the Leon A, Claire B scenario myself, but it's just such a damn good game. Like, for a PS1 game to do that, and it's not been replicated by modern games is crazy to me. I mean, this was RE2 Remake's chance to get that right, and it didn't do that, unfortunately. But yeah, moving on. Resident Evil 3 and Nemesis. It's going on the great section, because it's another great entry to the series. You're finally in Raccoon City. You're back as playing as Jill. It's a prequel slash epilogue to Resident Evil, you know, 2, and a sequel to Resident Evil 1, obviously. And it's just perfect. You get introduced to a nemesis who's constantly chasing you around, and you've got the choice system as well, where you have to make these decisions that affect the gameplay and the narrative. And you get, and again, it's just replay value. Like, this is another game you can put in and play over and over again just to get the different outcomes and the difficulty setting as well, whether you're playing on easy mode or hard mode. If you play on hard mode, you're going to get the extra bonus of being able to fight a nemesis and get these extra items from him if you choose to fight him. Whereas with easy mode, the game's, it's pretty simple enough, but you don't get the extra items, but you do get the assault rifle with Jill Stein at the beginning of the game, so that's pretty fun. And of course, you get the mind thrower if you play hard mode, so you get that. But yeah, and it introduced mercenaries mode as well to us, like the first concept version of mercenaries mode. Damn fun game, one of the best, and it's just, again, it's just a shame that RE3 Remake did not get that right. Resident Evil Survivor, I did play this. I'm gonna put it on meh. I thought it was meh. I don't think it was bad. You know, it's the first proper first-person RE game, but it just wasn't that interesting. And the biggest problem with this game is you can't even save. Like, you start the game and you pretty much have to finish it from beginning to end, and without dying. One of the cool things about this game though is how you get how early on in the game you get this key, right? And you get the choice of which route to take, and if you whichever route you take, that's where the story basically changes. So if you go in one route, you end up having to fight like these weird gorilla like hunter like characters that shoot at you, so it sort of becomes like a first person shooter. But if you go for like the other two options, you know, one leads to this area where you have to fight like hunters constantly, and the other one's like Mr. X's. So yeah, very, very nice kind of choice. Like the choice system of these games was always unique, and they weren't able to replicate it going forward, which is a shame. But yeah, overall, this game's a meh for me. Plus, it's never been brought up again. So yeah, Code Veronica. I want to put Code Veronica on the good section. I think this is one of the better RE games. But it's also one of the hardest ones. It brings back Chris. It brings back Claire. This is the true sequel to Resident Evil 1 and 2. It ties those storylines together. It brings back Wesker. And it sets up so much of the lore that we see in Resident Evil 5 especially. But and it introduces the Ashfords, of course. Terrible voice acting, by the way. Steven Birdseye, terrible voice acting. But the story and the narrative, I think, is pretty damn good. The lore is great. And it's got some of the best soundtracks in the series. But it is a hard game, unfortunately. But this is the one that I feel like needs to be remade. So yeah, definitely one of the good ones. Resident Evil Gaiden. Unfortunately, I never played this. I know what it's about. It wasn't received very well, I think. But it's weird. I feel like a lot of the story elements in this game, they ended up taking and doing their own versions of in later games going forward. But yeah, it was on the Game Boy, I believe. But yeah, I never played it. I think that's one of the main reasons why. Another one I never played was Resident Evil Gun Survivor 2. Apparently, this is a dream. This is all a dream that Claire's having on the plane on the way to from Rockford Island to the Antarctic. So it sort of ties into Code Veronica there, but it's all a dream apparently. So yeah, it's another first-person game as well. So that's kind of unique. And then we have the Resident Evil 1 remake. It's great. It's going up there. I don't think it's as good as Resident Evil 2 or 3. I think 2 and 3 are freaking amazing. But Resident Evil Remake is up there as one of the better ones. It's great. I think it's fantastic. There's really not much I can say. It does what Resident Evil 1 did, but better. So yeah, it simplifies some of the puzzles. It gives you new enemies. It gives you new features, and expands on the story. It has little ties into the other games, so that's fantastic. And overall, it just graphically, it looks better. And the script is a bit more tighter. So yeah, not more I can say about that. Resident Evil Zero is going in okay. I'm not a big fan of this game. I do kind of want to put it on bad. But the environments are great. The train section is a highlight. I think the whole final boss fight is fantastic. And the swapping system between Rebecca and Billy is unique. But why the hell did they not implement an item box? I will never know. And the hook shot just taking up too much space, like bloody hell. But I think it's one of the fun Resident Evil games. Like once you get the hang of it, I think you can have fun with this. But it's not my favorite one, that's for sure. Resident Evil, which one is this? Is this Dead Aim? I never played Dead Aim, unfortunately. Yeah, so that's going on the bottom. Yeah, unfortunately, yeah. Resident Evil Outbreak 1. So I'm gonna put this in. I don't know. Do I want to put this in okay or good? I want to put it in okay mode. I'm gonna put it in okay. I've only played this game once, and this was just a few years ago, like a good 4 or 5 years ago. I think I finally got around to getting this game. I went to Comic Con, I saw them selling it. I bought a copy of it. I got my PS2 out, my old ass PS2. I played it, and it was decent, but it wasn't great, mind you. I played our well, I'll get to it anyway. But yeah, as I like the idea of the fight scenarios. I like how you get to pick different characters, but I don't know, like something was just missing from it. I feel like after all the hype and years of hearing about this game and finally getting around to playing it, I just didn't think it was all that great. Moving on, Outbreak File 2. Yeah, I think this was better than Resident Evil Outbreak 1 in my opinion. The scenarios I think were better. This was the first one I actually played. I played Outbreak File 2 first. And this was like back in the like late 2000, like late 2000s, I think I got around to playing this. Was it? Yeah, it was mid 2000s, I think I played this game. I enjoyed it. You could walk and shoot. And the director for this would go on to direct Resident Evil 6, by the way. And the scenarios I think were better. Just the whole zoo section was great. The subway, going back to the RPT station. And then, what other scenarios were there? The whole woods section was terrific. That was like sort of a prelude to the village, not from RE4. You know, you had the Axeman instead of the Chainsaw Man. And of course, the final lab section was just a nightmare and the various ways you could complete that scenario. So yeah, this was definitely more of a fun one, I think. But I wish these games were available now to play online as well, because I feel like the best thing about these games is being able to play these online. Or I wish these were co-op as well. Like, I feel it's such a disappointing thing. Shame that Capcom did not have these be co-op games. Moving on, Resident Evil 4. I'm going to put in the good section. I know people already are going to like rip on me, and I'm going to put this... I want to put it here at top, obviously. Gameplay wise, I think it's better than Resident Evil 1 and Code Veronica. It's one of the most fun Resident Evil games, but I don't think it's great. And that's mostly because I don't like the narrative of the game. I feel like it doesn't do enough to develop the narrative, and some of the characters are obnoxious, and it's just a weird Resident Evil game to me. I remember the first time playing this, it was great. I had a lot of fun with it. But afterwards, I kind of sat down and was like, this isn't Resident Evil. Like, the narrative just doesn't make a lot of sense. Nothing's really explored that much. The characters feel very paper thin. I just wasn't a big fan of it, unfortunately, like, narrative-wise. I think as a game, it's great. It's one of the best games ever made. As a Resident Evil game, I don't think it's that great. It's that good. But still, I'm giving it the respect it deserves here, at least. The Resident Evil Umbrella Chronicles, I'm going to put in... okay. And I'm going to put it above... Should I put it there? I'm trying to remember, like, how good was this? Yeah, I'm going to put it there. It was kind of disappointing because I was really hoping they would properly reimagine the Resident Evil, like, the previous Resident Evil games. I think they did a decent job with Zero, and they did a decent job with One, because it's, like, the only time you kind of get this scenario where Jill and Chris are together, and the only time where Jill meets Rebecca as well, which is weird enough. But they completely messed up the... Resident Evil 3 scenario. I hated that. But I did like the extra scenarios that we got, like the exclusive ones, like showing how Ada survived Raccoon City, another Hank scenario basically that's a bit more story focused, and of course the new additions to the lore and storyline with Wesker, and seeing what he was up to before the events of Resident Evil 0, or after it actually, or before it maybe. And then, of course, how he escaped the mansion, how he came back to life, and then getting to play as him as well, like, was kind of fun. But it is a rail shooter, that's the key thing. It's a rail shooter, you're just kind of pointing and shooting, basically, and you get the occasional quick time element. But I did like the exclusive scenario with Umbrella's End, playing as Chris and Jill, and having to put an end to Umbrella, finally. But I just wish it was its own game, and I wish it was bigger, I wish it was longer, I wish this was a Wesker game that we could have played as Wesker in third person, or maybe first person, you know, whichever would have worked better instead of being a rail shooter, but I think it's fine. Moving on, Resident Evil 5, I think is one of the good games. I'm going to put it above Resident Evil 4, because I think this was better than Resident Evil 4. As a Resident Evil game, I thought it was a proper Resident Evil game. I liked the real-time element of having to pause, you know, you couldn't pause the game. You had to make decisions on the fly. You had a very select inventory space. And I liked the story. I liked Wesker. You know, I liked the fact that they decided to make a proper sequel to Code Veronica, unlike Resident Evil 4, which just felt like a side game. They brought Wesker back. I thought it was great. DC Darkness as Wesker was amazing in that game. A lot of the sections and scenarios and parts of the game, like the whole boat section was great. The whole having to escape, you know, fight two Chainsaw Man at the same time in the old refinery, exploring the ruins and doing that whole laser puzzle, and that was great. Dodging the lasers in that whole section, I think it was great. Ouroboros, that whole boss fight. Basically, all the boss fights at Ouroboros I thought were fantastic. And using the flamethrower, having to lure it into the incinerator, having to use the satellite laser, the boss fights with Wesker, fighting Jill. It's just, I feel like, Resident Evil-wise, this was a better game. And I can't wait to see what they do with a remake. I do hope they improve the story a bit, you know, give a bit more depth to Sheba and Josh, and develop some of the side characters a bit more, and give Jill a bigger role. Other than that, I think it's fantastic, and the DLC was fantastic for this game. So yeah, definitely one of my favorite ones. Resident Evil Dark Side Chronicles, I'm gonna actually put in... do I think this is actually good or okay? I like this game, but I'm gonna put it in okay. But it's gonna be top. For one, the remixing of the soundtracks from Resident Evil 2 and Code Veronica, fantastic. This is what the soundtrack should have sounded like for the remix for Resident Evil 2. The original storyline that they give us, Operation Javier, with starring Leon and Krauser, fantastic. You know, as a prequel to Resident Evil 4 and how it leads to that, fantastic. The fact they bring the Code Veronica virus back, fantastic. And the way they have you play Krauser's scenario and you get in his thoughts at the end and how he becomes sort of a villain, fantastic. Just good all around. But my only disappointment with this game really is they do a good job with reimagining Resident Evil 2 and sort of remaking it in the rail shooter format. And then Code Veronica is pretty damn great up until you get to an Antarctica and you finish the Claire segment, and then you play as Chris, and it's so disappointing that we don't get an entire Chris section. I mean, we had all those levels because the original Dark Side Chronicles is a co-op game, but when you're playing the Wesker scenario, I think, and the single player parts, that's all one player. So it's kind of disappointing they didn't do that with Dark Side Chronicles and give us that one single player element of Chris and seeing his point of view when he's on Rockford Island and going through Antarctica and trying to find Claire. Other than that, I think it's fantastic. I don't like the addition of Alexia killing Alfred. I think that sucks. But other than that, I think it's great. So, yeah. Resident Evil Mercenaries 3D. I never played this, so that's going up there. Resident Evil Revelations 1 is going to go on. Yeah, I'm going to put this in the okay mode. I'm going to put it... Yeah, I'm going to put it at the top. I like Revelations 1, but I don't think it's good. It's weird for me. I feel like the first half of this game is great, but then the second half just sort of falls apart, and I don't like the constant switching to various characters. I think it ruins the pacing of the game when it turns from this sort of very survival horror element game and then into an action game. Like, I get they were trying to balance it, but it just didn't work for me. And a lot of the characters, side characters, I didn't really gel with, if that makes sense. And the ship scenario was great. And obviously, the original 3DS, you know, it was first person when you were in combat and third person when you were exploring. I think that's very similar to what they did with Dead Aim. I never played Dead Aim, but I know Dead Aim was designed like that. And they kind of took that and copied that element of it. But other than that, I think it's decent. I like the sections of Rachel and when you're getting chased. It feels very Nemesis-like. But other than that, I think it's sort of a meh game, unfortunately. Which one is this? Is this Operation Raccoon City? Yeah, I never played it. So, yeah. Hard pass, unfortunately, for me there. Resident Evil 6. I'm going to put it in good. But I'm going to put it at the bottom because it is one of the flawed Resident Evil games. I do agree this game is super flawed, but I had fun with it. I think as a co-op game, it's fantastic. I think the Chris Pierce scenario is great. Jake and Sherry, I think, are fantastic characters. The scenario is not their best, but it did offer them a more open world element to them. You know, you get to explore certain sections and do some certain things. The Leon and Helena campaign is one of the weaker ones, actually. It's got highlights and it's got some of the highest and lowest in my opinion. I do like Leon though in this game, but I don't like Helena. I think her character is absolute trash. Her arc is trash. Ada is her campaign. I think the first two chapters are fine, but then the rest of the campaign is absolute trash. And technically, she's like the main character, and she's absolutely wasted in this. It is a flawed game, but I do think it's got some of the biggest highs and biggest lows overall. But I do think it's a good game. It's just not a very good Resident Evil game, and especially coming off from Resident Evil 5, I feel like they needed to go a bit more down, but I don't think it's just okay. It's got a lot of good elements. I like how you can play the very different characters, and each character's got their own weapons and movesets and that, so I like that, so that's very fun. It's got that replay ability there because of that. Revelations 2, I'm going to put in great. I don't think it's as good as these three games. But it is definitely one of the better ones, and it's sort of the precursor to or progenitor of to that leads to the Resident Evil 4 remake, especially because it's the same director as well, the one that made Revelations 2 ended up doing Resident Evil 4 remake. It's one of the more fun Resident Evil games. I think it's better than Resident Evil Revelations 1. The story's better. It continues off. It ties up loose ends from the Resident Evil 5 game. I like that. And you get to play as Barry, and they bring Claire back, and you play as her. So I think that was fantastic. I didn't mind switching between characters, but like it did get very repetitive and annoying. So I do kind of wish they'd made it feel a bit better and how that handles. But I like the fact that this is sort of like the first stealth Resident Evil game, and I like the stealth. Whenever I could use it, I tried to use it. Fantastic. And it's the one thing that also sort of brought up the zapping system from Resident Evil 2, where if you did certain things in one campaign, certain things might be different in the other campaign. So I thought that was fantastic. And Alex Wesker is a fun villain. And is probably the only villain in the series that wins, actually, if you consider that. So yeah. Umbrella Corps, never played it, so that's going there. Resident Evil 7 is one of the great games, I think. I think it's definitely better than... do I think it's better than Remake? That's the problem. I feel like this is one of the best Resident Evil games, in my opinion. Yeah, I think it's a great Resident Evil game, but is it as good as 2 and 3? I'm sort of biased. I keep flip-flopping. That's the problem. I keep flip-flopping with this game because I think it's absolutely fantastic. It semi-reboots the series. It brings it down to the original Resident Evil level. And the story and the themes, I think, are fantastic. Lucas is a great villain. Jack is a fun villain that chases you around. I think that's great. The house design, the boathouse, the whole, yeah, I think is just great. And I like the boat section, actually. A lot of people don't like that, but I don't mind the boat section. So yeah, I'm gonna put it in the middle there. I think it's one of the best Resident Evil games made. I loved it. Resident Evil 2 Remake, I think, is good. Do I like it more than Resident Evil 4? I think absolutely. Do I like it more than Resident Evil 5? See, that's the problem there. I'm going to put it here. Just to play it safe, I'm going to put it there. I think it's a good remake. I don't think it's a great remake. The lack of a zapping system and the intercrossing scenarios was a disappointment. It's what brings it down for me. But I think it's a fantastic remake overall. That's got great atmosphere, great tone. And the gameplay's fun. And it's very it's easy to pick up and play, I feel like. So I think just for that, it's... It deserves its spot there. Resident Evil Resistance, never played it. I don't play the online stuff here, unfortunately. Resident Evil 3. I'm gonna... I don't think it's bad. I think... I don't know if I want to put it in okay, though. Because this is the thing. So I think it's better than Resident Evil 0, though. Yeah. I think it's better than Resident Evil 0. But I don't think it's a good remake. I think it's a terrible remake, but I think it's a good game. Does that make sense? Like, for what it is, it's good. For what it isn't, it's absolutely terrible. But it's got a great soundtrack. They do what Resident Evil 2 Remake didn't do, which is take the soundtrack and reimagine it and remix it, and they did that right. The hospital scenario is great. The chemistry between Jill and Carlos is fantastic. And I do like the Nemesis boss fights, and Nikolai is a great villain than this. And they expand Tyro as well. Like, they take him and they make him into a better character. But everything else, absolute trash in my opinion. But I think it is a fun Resident Evil game to play. I like the dodging mechanic and that, so... I just wish it had more Nemesis. I wish they stayed true to the original game and just expanded that instead of this feeling like a DLC. So yeah, but I do think it's fine. Yeah. Resident Evil Village, it's going into good section. I feel like this is a better Resident Evil 4 in my opinion. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna put it above the original Resident Evil 4. I think it's a better Resident Evil 4. I like the lords. I like the different sections where you get to play. You know, you get to explore. The castle is great. The whole Heisenberg factory is great. The more puzzle focused house Benovito section is great. Mario section is the one that sort of lacks, but I do like his boss fight. And I like the whole Chris section, getting to play as him and kicking ass and that was fun. The story, I think, is wonderful. I think how they continue and conclude Ethan's story is fantastic. And yeah, I think it's one of the better Resident Evil games, definitely. I had a lot of fun. It's basically Resident Evil 4 in first person view, and I think it's great for that. It's fantastic. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, there's really not a lot I could say other than that. I think it's a good game. Great? No, I don't think it's great. I don't think it's great. I certainly think there's a few flaws here and there. I wish you'd got to interact with more NPCs and that, but I don't know. I think it's definitely a better Resident Evil 4. I feel like it does what Resident Evil 4 should have done story-wise. Moving on, RE:Verse. Never played it, and then finally we got Resident Evil 4 remake, and that's going on great, and it's going to be the top one. It's hands down my favorite Resident Evil game. I know it's weird, isn't it? I'm sort of complaining about Resident Evil 4, but Resident Evil 4 Remake takes everything I didn't like about Resident Evil 4 and improves it. The story is better, the characters are better. Yeah, you lose the banter between the villains, unfortunately, which is the only thing I kind of really enjoyed in the original Resident Evil 4. But the lore is better. Like, everything's explained, everything's expanded. U3's explained, how they combine that with the other Vertigo, I think is handled better. Separate Ways as a campaign is far, far better. Ada's voice actor aside, I think it's a better campaign than the original campaign. They take all the content that wasn't in the base game, they took the best ones and they expanded upon it or reinvented it, and they put it into the Separate Ways campaign. Just far better, I feel like. And a soundtrack was an improvement, and yeah, like, that was great. I liked the chemistry between Leon and Krauser in this a lot more than the original. He doesn't just come out of nowhere. I like that, like, that he's like Leon's teacher now, like his mentor. Just fantastic. The stealth elements, the things they took from Revelations 2 and improved upon here. The parry system, just fantastic. It's just a great bloody game. It's the best Resident Evil game in my opinion, and I feel like it's gonna be the one that's gonna be hard to top. But yeah, guys, that's my tier list. I hope you like that. And yeah, I might do more of these actually. But yeah, I thought I'd do Resident Evil first because I'm trying to make my channel more Resident Evil focused, basically. But yeah, this was fun to do, man. I can't wait to see what we get with Resident Evil 9, man. I'm just waiting for that, and I can't wait to see what they do with future remakes as well. But yeah, because it's gonna be fun to play those and then go back to this one day. But yeah, I had a fun time with this, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. And yeah, I had fun doing this. So yeah, guys, yeah, remember to like and subscribe as always, and I shall see you when I shall see you. Take care.